right? I believe most of the people have joined the session. So to get started, we're gonna go ahead and have a quick introduction about the product. And before that, I'll go ahead and have some ground rules set up. So basically, at any point, if you have any technical questions, you could just very well go ahead and type in the questions on the question section window. Or we also have a raise hand feature so that you could just go ahead and click on that, and we would be able to go ahead and unmute you on the webinar, and so that you would be able to go ahead and talk in the webinar, and you could go ahead and discuss about your technical queries that you have. So today's agenda is going to be like, we're going to have a quick introduction about the product, then the architecture, deployment, how it works, demo, and disaster recovery scenarios, and Q&A. And to talk about Wembu Technologies was founded in 2004, and it's a private company, and we've been profitable since 2006. And Wembu Technologies is an headquarters in Chennai, India. And we have about 4,000 channel partners who in turn reach out to 60,000 businesses. So 70% of our customers are from North America, and 20% from Europe, and 10% from Asia Pacific. And so we're going to go ahead and have a quick introduction about Wembu BDR Suite. So Wembu BDR Suite is a one-stop solution to all your backups and DR needs. So basically, it's a kind of a cluster wherein you could go ahead and use a single product to go ahead and perform different environment backups. So basically, you could use VM backup to perform backup and replication for VMware and Hyper-V, image backups for physical servers and desktops to perform a backup and bare metal recovery, and network backup, which is a backup solution for files and folders, applications like Exchange, SQL, SharePoint, Active Directory, MySQL, etc. And the last one is online backup, which is also a solution wherein you could go ahead and use it to backup files and folders, applications like Exchange, SQL, SharePoint, Active Directory, Outlook, wherein in turn you could go ahead and have that backup running directly to our own cloud. And so why we go ahead and recommend Wembu VM backup is like, basically, when you go ahead and perform backups using different backup softwares, you have various challenges. So basically, if you're backing up a virtual or a physical server, it's more expensive and it's difficult to manage. And all you know, it's as well, all you know that it requires a fundamentally different approach. And for that, we go ahead and have this Wembu VM backup, which is going to be a one-stop solution, which is exclusively designed for backing up physical and virtual environments. Wembu fills a purpose here to be the best of breed technology in providing manageable solutions in affordable cost for both physical and virtual server, along with applications that resides in the system, and also a cloud optional disaster recovery. And now we'll go ahead and have this presented to Nagaraj, who is one of our technical architect, who would go ahead and have a quick introduction about the product, and he's going to go ahead and discuss about disk image backups in detail.
Thanks, Tyagarajan. Hi guys, good morning. Myself, Nagarajan. So today I'm going to talk about the physical Windows servers, desktops and laptops backup. It will be like an image level backup, and it supports bare metal recovery and virtual machine recoveries as well. So I'm going to talk about in detail about this particular solution offered by Wembu. So before we get into the solution, I would like to discuss about the challenges faced by the IT administrators nowadays. See, when you consider a data center, I mean, say it may be a physical servers, or it may be a virtual servers, or whatever it may be. But these are all the challenges faced by the IT administrators. So how can I ensure the business continuity? So there are, disasters happen unexpectedly. So how can I ensure the business continuity? So, and how fast I can recover the data during the disaster? And how can I avoid the data loss during disaster, as well as the exponential data growth? Okay, when you go for a backup software, say you may have terabytes of data, so you should make sure that you have enough storage to handle all those data and the historical data. Sometime we would like to keep more than 10 years of backup data. So it's a bigger problem when you go for a backup software. And last two questions are like add-on, where most of the IT administrators might have different products, expensive products perform last two activities, where how can I rely on my backups? Like though you may run a backup job, how can you make sure whether the backup job is up to date and it will work when the disaster happens? Also, it's a one add-on service which is given by Vembu, where migration plans, okay, for migration plans in physical servers, you would like to migrate the physical servers to VMware or Hyper-V as a VM, but for that particular purpose, you may force to purchase a separate software or separate solution, which might be more expensive. So Vembu actually provide add-on service for these particular challenges as well. Okay, let me explain it in detail. Okay, before we get into the solutions offered by Vembu, I would like to just clarify what is RTO and RPO. So in a backup server, when we talk about backup and disaster recovery, RTO is pretty much important. I mean, the time duration to recover a backed up machine after disaster, say how fast you can boot a machine after disaster occurs. Okay, this is provide you the downtime, so you cannot shut down a machine which is a business critical machine not more than 10 minutes or 5 minutes or 15 minutes. Okay, Vembu here provide 15 minutes RTO as well as RPO, recovery point objective. By providing once in every 15 minutes backup, we actually offer customers a 15 minutes RPO as well. Okay, when we talk about how fast I can recover the servers during disaster, Vembu actually provide solution where you can instantly boot a machine when disaster strikes. So if you have enough resource on your backup server in your data center, you can instantly boot the machine in less than 60 seconds. So to boot a machine virtually, you can use instant virtual machine recovery options. Also, in case if you would like to restore specific files and folders, you can use instant file level recovery. Also, Vembu offers free explorers for Microsoft Exchange mail level recoveries and SharePoint document level recoveries and SQL database level recovery, as well as the Active Directory user and group policy level recoveries. All of them are at free of cost Vembu is offering. All you need to do is you have to only pay for the backups you are going to do for the physical machines. And when we talk about the data loss, how can I avoid a data loss? So we recommend you to run the backup once in every 15 minutes. So you can make sure you cannot lose up to 15 minutes worth of data. So that's why we provide 15 minutes of RPO. Also, we offer replication for the virtual machines, where you can instantly replicate the machine, a virtual machine from VMware or Hyper-V environment to the host VMware or Hyper-V host. In terms of the physical machines, you can just use the frequency, backup frequencies every 15 minutes. So you can make sure the RPO is less than 15 minutes. And how can I rely on my backups? Okay, this is a question, important question, where it's not about running backups every 15 minutes. It's about all those backups are consistent. So you Vembu offers automatic backup verification, where it instantly boots after every backup schedule or once in a day as per your schedule. It boots a machine virtually on native Hyper-V and it takes a screenshot, and the screenshot will be stored in the user interface and it will be sent as a mail to you as well. So you can just verify the screenshot and make sure your backup is up to date and your backup is recoverable. So you no need to panic during the disaster strikes. And the data growth, when we talk about backups, it's not only running the backups during every 15 minutes or keeping data for 10 years, okay, whatever it may be. So you should have enough storage to store the backup data. Though the data is compressed and deduplicated, again, the managing the data in data store, I mean the storage repositories, actually requires much more technology, where other vendors in the market are using the native technology which is given by the hardware vendors. Vembu actually developed its own file system, Vembu Hi file system, to store the backed up data. What is the benefits towards Vembu Hi file system? Okay, it has inbuilt version control, inbuilt compression and deduplication, and inbuilt encryption, and most importantly, inbuilt error correction. Since it's our own file system, we know how it actually operates. And you can easily actually add any kind of a disk, whether it may be a directly attached disk, or it may be a SAN, or it may be a NAS. You can just combine them in a single storage repository, and the data can be stored in anywhere on those disks. So you can just eliminate the requirements where some vendors actually would like you to force to use only SAN or NAS or DAS, but you can all those the properties can be eliminated by using the Vembu Hi file system. And another one important add-on which is given by Vembu is where you can instantly boot the backed up images virtually without using any additional storage. So by using that, you can create a virtual lab where, say for example, for your physical machine which is having a Windows 2012 and it's running Exchange server inside, and if you would like to migrate it into a VMware or Hyper-V, before migrating it, you should make sure whether the machine works properly on a VMware or Hyper-V environment. For that purpose, we provide, you can use Vembu Media Suite, and you can just instantly boot them on Hyper-V or VMware or KVM, and you can just let it run for a couple of days, and you can make sure the performance and other activities, and once you are satisfied, you can just migrate your physical machine in permanently into any virtualization environment. Say in most of the data centers, most of the servers and servers are actually virtualized, but still some of the customers are running the the applications inside a physical machine to get a better performance, where they are not actually okay with running the application servers which requires much resources. But however, they may have a plan laterally to migrate those machines into virtual environment. For that purpose, we provide a concept of virtual lab where you can create a virtual lab instantly without using any additional storage, and you can just instantly boot the data from the storage repositories. All can be possible only by the Vembu Hi file system, because it's it's our own file system. We know how the data is stored, that's why we easily instantly read them, and we instantly create the image, and we instantly create a virtual machine. And the migration plan. Okay, as I said earlier, you can just instantly migrate without a minimal downtime. The physical machines can be permanently migrated into VMware or Hyper-V. So once a backup job is completed, Vembu Hive file system instantly creates the images like VHD, VHDX, and VMDK and IMG files instantly without using any additional storage. So you can use any one of those images, and you can just move them to a data store, VSXi data store, or a Hyper-V storage. Then you can just create a virtual machine and permanently migrate a physical machine into virtualization environment. Okay, whenever we create those images, we actually inject the required drivers for each and every hypervisors. So no need to worry that you have to manually inject the drivers after booting it in the virtualization environment. Okay, let me move into the architecture diagram, how it actually works in terms of physical server and desktop image backups. As I said, we back up the Windows physical servers and desktops and laptops. We actually have an agent called VM Backup Client Agent. That agent has to be installed inside the physical machines, and we actually developed our own proprietary driver which will be installed inside the machine, and it actually tracks and change the blocks. And we use Microsoft VSS to take a snapshot, and during the initial full backup, the entire image will be transferred to the Vembu Media backup server, and during the incremental only the changes will be tracked, and it will be sent to the backup server. And the Vimbu VM backup agent works as a proxy, and it collects the data and it compresses it and encrypts it while transferring the data over the WAN, and the data will be stored in the Vimbu PDR backup server storage repository. Okay, so this is the architecture. It's a very simple where it's only two-tier architecture where the client agent has to be installed in the source machine and the backup server which has been installed in anywhere like a physical or virtual environment. And it collects the data and it sends it to the backup server. Backup server data receives the data and it stores it in the storage repository. So you can install the physical servers, the Vimbu PDR backup server in a physical machine or a virtual machine. It's up to you. Say in case if you need instant boot options, we recommend you to install Vimbu PDR backup server in Windows 2012 or 2008 R2 by enabling the Hyper-V role. Okay, this is a simple deployment where you can install a Vimbu PDR backup server on a Linux machine, like a Ubuntu or a Windows on your local environment, and you can just backup all your physical Windows servers, desktops, laptops to the same Vimbu PDR backup server. And another deployment scenario what we support is, say in case if you would like to keep another copy of your backed up data on cloud where you would like to deploy hybrid deployment, we offer Vimbu Cloud DR service where you can just enable it and the one copy of your backup data will be stored into Vimbu Cloud. We run our cloud service on Amazon Web Services across all continents. We have data center in the US East, West and Europe and Australia as well. In case if you would like to send another copy of, in case if you would like to keep multiple copies in the same data center, or you would like to send another copy to your data center, you can use another service called Vimbu Offset DR service. By using that, you can just deploy a disaster recovery DR site, server on your remote location, and one copy of your backup data can be sent to the remote location over WAN or LAN. And you can use them in case your entire site went down, you can just instantly boot your entire site from the DR server. Also, in case if some customers would like to keep the data, sync the servers between sites, like a remote office and branch office setup, where they want to keep the servers, what are all running in the site one would be synced to site two, and the site two servers synced to the site one, so that they can just function when any one of the site went down. In this scenario, we recommend you to install Vimbu PDR backup server and offset DR server in both the locations, and send one copy of the data from site one to site two, and a copy of data from site 2 to site 1. So by transferring the data across the sites, you can keep backup data of both the machines. In case if you would like to start a server, during the initial deployment, if hundreds of physical machines are connecting to one single Vimbu PDR backup server, later on, if you would like to increase the servers count, if you just add another 100 desktops in your workstation and you would like to backup all of them to the same server, and if it is not enough to handle all those requests, you can just bring another machine which has similar resource and you can just add them with the existing server. Okay, instead just shut down the backup server machine and increase the resources of the backup server machine. You can just add another server with the existing server. Vimbu PDR backup server has its own clustering algorithm to load balance the request across the backup servers. So without having any downtime, you can just add multiple servers to manage the backup loads. Okay, now how it works, when we come to Windows image level backup, how it actually works. Okay, so as I said, we use VSS, Volume Shadow Copy service, to take the snapshot of entire disk, and by using that, we actually backup the initial full image backup. Then we use our own proprietary driver, which is which will be installed inside the machine, and it will again track the changes during the incremental backup. So during the incremental backup, it only track the changes, and the changes alone will be sent to the backup servers. And we support Windows XP SP2 onwards, and you can even backup Windows 2003 SP2 onwards. Say since Windows